Good morning, guys. It's a very exciting day today. I'm heading over to my double-decker bus to see the latest transformations. As a lot of you know, I've been converting this bus over the last almost year now, on and off, and I've shown you the progress along the way. We put a hot tub upstairs. It's been completely transformed, completely converted. And Mike Moore, my friend Mike, has been heading up that entire project. Now, recently, for various reasons, but my friend Jim, who's just recently been with us in the US on our road trip, he is, he's taken over the project. He has done some pretty dramatic changes. Unfortunately, we've had to switch the hot tub out because there was problems with the original one. There's just been ongoing problems, but anyway, we will see today what he's been doing, and I think it's almost completed. The other thing I need to tell you is that I've had a really strange week, and after my mad weekend at the stag do, or bachelor party for those of you watching from the States, and taking those jet surf boards out, I got really ill. So I've been resting up for a few days and I'm just getting back into the swing of it. If you didn't check out the bachelor party or stag do vlog, please check that out. I'll link it below. It was a very, very epic day. But today is also going to be epic, and we're going to see the bus. Let's go see the bus. So before we have a look around the lived adventure bus, we're having a little look at the boom bus. You guys know about the boom bus. This is now living here at Jim's yard, and he's kindly got some people in to clean it out for me.
I'm here with Laura and Rachel as well.
Yes, bro.
Oh, it's smelling a lot better.
Yeah, isn't it?
It's just a lot better.
I mean, I don't think it will ever be clean again.
No, no. There's probably a bunch of stuff in here that I've like been looking for years.
I'm just what we've done is we've boxed up all like potentially good stuff.
Yeah, okay. No, this is a MIDI saxophone.
We threw away things like, cat litter and poo in it. We knew what was junk and what wasn't.
Yeah, yeah, fair enough. I was actually looking for that, though.
I've definitely got some emotional memories on here.
Yeah.
This was my bed.
I just love the sound system.
Yeah. And there's boxes of stuff all under here.
Yeah, all my tools and stuff like that.
So we haven't thrown away anything that was obviously not rubbish.
Guys, check out my sound system. This is a serious sound system right here. So as you can see, Jim has a lot of buses he's looking after here. This is his whole business. If any of you guys need a bus built or converted, Jim's your lad. Right, Jim, take us around the bus. Show us what you've been doing.
Right.
It's been a while.
It has been a while, hasn't it? So there's no major changes, really.
You may notice, guys, that the all the cladding has changed.
Yeah.
Which I'm thinking is looking pretty cool. Obviously, all the original work surface and these units are in.
So there's no major design changes.
Yeah.
That way, but there's a lot of cladding changes. And we've managed to sort of clad all the way over the ceiling as well to turn it into more of a...
I do like this. I was wondering whether this would feel a little bit too much like we're in like a ship, like an old pirate ship, but
the option is
kind of like it.
Potentially whitewash the ceiling.
Yeah.
To give it some light. But I mean...
I like it. I do like it.
It's cabin-y, but nice.
It's still going to be lacquered as well, so that will really bring out the colour.
And these window frames as well.
Yeah, so we tried to kind of take away any of the original shapes or to take the original bus away, so the curved windows and things like that.
Yeah, originally we had the lights in that were still kind of the original lights from the bus.
Yeah, so you had those boxes all the way across, didn't you? There was too many original bits of bus, and what we like to try and do is take it away from looking like a bus.
Yeah.
Which I think has worked really well.
Yeah, love it. And I like these new light fittings, these are cool.
Yeah, we're
a bit more rustic.
Like this is what we've done with a lot of motorhomes, is kind of go with the industrial kind of look. The galvanized steel, things like that. So, and they've all got kind of really nice filament bulbs because they light out really well.
Like we're jotting down a few ideas for final changes down here. Gonna head upstairs now.
Ooh. Continuation of all the cladding. Oh yeah, nice.
Cladded all these banisters as well, so that's nice solid.
Yeah, I like that. Less flimsy, because the other one was a bit flimsy, wasn't it? Yeah.
Adding lights on the stairwell on the way up. We're getting, we're cladding over these, and cladding over this whole section, just to make it more usable.
Yeah.
So as you can see here. And then we'll vinyl over the window on the outside, just so you don't know.
Yeah, better. And what we think about the ceiling?
Same again as downstairs.
Yeah.
Clad the ceiling.
All right.
So we're just really working our way up at the moment.
What we're thinking, guys, is putting a futon here, so this could be another little potential bedroom area. And maybe also on a future date is taking these panels out so they're removable. We've got a bit of headroom inside because it's pretty small in here. All right, let's check outside. Right, new hot tub.
Yeah.
Now it doesn't look quite as rustic. The aesthetic on the inside is not quite as cool as the cylindrical tub, but that had a lot of issues. Was it like the, it wasn't built for moving around, was it?
It had to always have water in it, which isn't good for this bus, because you're going to have times when it hasn't got water.
And in the bottom of the other hot tub, it was getting really stagnant and nasty.
But the good thing is with this is that we're going to clad right up to this lip.
Okay.
So from the outside, it will look like a rustic tub.
Nice.
It's just the framework, the interior is maintenance free. We can wash it, clean it. It can sit empty.
Yeah.
Proper cover for it.
It's going to be a lot better for commercial use if we're like, or when we're renting it out for big events and stuff, we can.
It's got its own built-in sound system as well, so you can just plug speakers straight in.
It's got its own sound system.
Its own amp, everything. You know, if you go to like public swimming pools, you get like a big fountain.
Yeah.
Thing that, you know, massages your back or whatever.
Uh huh.
Thinking of having something like that here that will make that will fill the hot tub.
Okay. Yeah.
So
and that's just a permanent. I like that.
So at least when the hot tub's filling up, it's not just like a hose pipe like it was.
Yeah, yeah.
A bit of white tube, it's going to be a nice funnel fill.
Yeah.
And then what we'll do is put some shower heads that come out back.
I like that.
Maybe we can get a bit rustic with them with some galv and copper.
That'd be cool. Okay, guys, last time I was here, we just fitted the big generator. Was it 8 kilowatt?
I think it might be more than that.
But we're just going to fire it up. Jim's going to show me how loud it is, because apparently it's a pretty quiet one.
You can imagine this is actually going to be an insulated wall.
Yeah.
It's hardly any noise.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
But when that's a solid wall, there's no air gap.
Yeah, double cross.
Not a lot of vibration or anything.
Yeah, really. No, like that
size generator.
And that's a lot of power.
Yeah.
That'll heat the tub.
I mean, the water here is 3 kVA.
Yeah.
So that running at max would be about 7, even though it says it's 8, it won't be a full power.
The
water heater is 3.
And we could run a big sound system off it.
A massive sound system. I mean, we'll never even.
And maybe boil a kettle for a cup of tea.
Of that generator.
Yeah. It's really quiet outside, like way quieter than a car engine running.
And it's tapped into the fuel tank
off
the bus now as well.
Oh, nice.
So it's only
time to head off. We've just had a kind of idea. Don't know if we're going to pull it off or not, but we're thinking, although we've originally gone with this matte black colour and we've got the vinyl to do it, would it be better to go with the kind of LTA blue that's on our website and part of the logo? Would it be cooler as a big blue bus? We're thinking it would be cooler. So Jim's gonna do some research, see if we can get it done in time for a festival that we're taking the bus to in a few weeks, the Secret Garden Party. Don't know if any of you guys are gonna be heading over there, but we're gonna take the bus. And hopefully if all goes to plan, if we can get a guy to wrap it in time, we're gonna completely transform the outside. And then we're gonna go have some vinyl lettering for the Live the Adventure logo and the aeroplane and stuff, rather than the spray paint that we had on it before, which will look a bit more pro. It's gonna be good. It's gonna be really good. See you later, Jim.
Yeah.
Thanks for all the work. See you later, girls.
Bye.
Oh, right. It's got me pumped again for the bus. I think because it's taken so long over the last year, like I said, I've kind of lost enthusiasm and ongoing enthusiasm. And I've just thought, you know, I'll wait until it's really up and running. Obviously, we've used it for a few events. We had the LTA Summit. We had our little movie night over Christmas. And so there's been a few things, but I'm glad that over the summer we're going to be able to use it, at least for one festival, which was the original plan. We've learnt a lot in this process, in hindsight. There's been a lot of things that are trickier than you would imagine trying to put a hot tub on a bus. I mean, you would imagine it's tricky. It is. But it's, yeah, it's almost there. We are almost, the finish line is in sight. So get ready. And then hopefully once it's all launched, I can, it can be available for you guys to rent out, or any companies, people watching that want to use it for events. That is the plan, that we want to have it all across the country doing really cool things with it, as well as some pretty epic road trips and events with the LTA crew. And then me and Jim were saying, potentially, one day, maybe we could ship it over to America to do a little tour around there. But we'll see. Maybe that's like next year. Right, I'm heading off now. I need to go and sort out a few things, see some friends, and it's my friend's birthday tonight, so I'm gonna be busy. I will catch you guys tomorrow. Peace out, enjoy life, and live the adventure. Boom.